What's going on, guys? I'm the Mr. Malrow and welcome to this video. You are watching Need for Speed Most Wanted and I am driving the Hennessy Venom. Well, I was, just to give you a little demonstration of what this is like. Now, as you can see straight away, I'm going pretty fast already. I'm at about 200 as soon as I started the race. And that's not good. It's good if you like fast cars, but it's not good if you're someone that doesn't want to pay £8 for the DLC. Now, this video is basically going to be about me complaining about Criterion Games, the scum of the racing game genre. I've been having sending in a few complaints to them over Twitter recently, and they've seemed to have started to ignore me, and, you know, just because it's fine, it's what you do, really, don't you? You don't fight back or anything. You just ignore them, so that's fine. But the reason I was complaining was because of this bullshit new game they've released, Most Wanted, which was, it's okay, it's not too bad, it's not the best game in the world, it's definitely not the best, and it's not the worst, it's low down, but it's not the worst. It's better than Hot Pursuit, but it's not better than The Run. Getting to the point. This game, they released £8 DLC for it, so £7.99, £4 on a sale, whatever you want, I don't care, you still have to pay real money for it. And some people don't wish to spend money on cars they don't want. For example, I don't really like the Hennessy Venom. I think it's a clunky car. And I also say that because I can't drive, as you can see here. But anyway, the point is I don't want to spend £8 on cars I don't like. But Criterion are forcing me to do that because I was in an SLS and the SLS can keep up with Veyrons and fly past them, whatever. But as soon as you see a Hennessy Venom online, you can't beat it. No chance in hell unless the driver is an alcoholic and also has been smoking weed. But it just gets to 200 in a second. It's nothing to it. And to keep up with it, to have a chance against it, you need to buy the DLC yourself and drive the exact same car. So if I don't want to use the Hennessy Venom, I'm going to lose. If I want to use the Hennessy Venom, I'm always going to win. Well, unless there's another Hennessy Venom. So at the point, it's going to get to a point where every person is using a Hennessy Venom. No one else is using anything else. And it just pisses me off. I don't want to use a Hennessy Venom. The whole point for Most Wanted was all cars are equal, all cars can keep the same. They've done it since The Run, even if the cars aren't the same, you have stupid amounts of knots and stupid amounts of acceleration if you're behind. And that was perfect. They didn't release any cars that gave you a stupid advantage over what the cars are already in the game. This is a joke. It gets to about 275, no problem at all. And the other cars sometimes struggle to get to 200. And if you want to win a race, you have to pay £8. They did it with this, they did it with Hot Pursuit, and they also did it with Burnout Paradise. It is you, Criterion. You are scum. What are you? Scum. Oh, well, they didn't do it in Burnout. I did that. Stop talking. What about the Island DLC, or the Legends DLC, and all that other bollocks they released? If you didn't buy at least one of those bits of DLC, you had no chance of keeping up. If you have the Island, and you have done everything on the Island, you get a car that is unstoppable. They've done it with this, they've done it with Hot Pursuit, and they've done it with Burnout. And yes, that is loading. The game actually loads because this car is so fast. And they're too lazy to put an install on the PS3 version. Criterion, you are scum and I will never buy a game from you again. Go away, please. And don't come back. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.